to Suzanne. I know I saw her that she was online.
Mm-hmm. I'm here.
Great. You want to go ahead and ask your question?
Yeah, I'm having problems. I need to have users do a lookup to the pages library on a site and choose several. It could be multi-value, and then have that post a link onto a page. And when I do that, when I do the lookup field, I only get access to title, but it seems to me that it's name that actually has the link to the page. So I don't know how to make that appear.
Uh-huh. So your lookup column contains multiple links, choice, and they are in a form of just URL.
Yeah. Yes. I want when the user clicks on it, I want that page to open up. But all I get is the properties.
Oh, I think I understand what you're talking about. You actually get a property. So hold on, one thing. Lookup column is looking up values from a list where you have a list of URLs, correct?
No, maybe I should do that. But what I'm looking up is, you know, information already appears on site, pages library.
Mm-hmm. And when you click on that value, you get to the property. I'm trying to understand. I don't know.
No, I think I understand what she's saying. What she's saying is that she's got a title field, which is the name or something, and that's the only field that's available as a lookup field. What she wants is a field that has the actual link to the document, and when people click on that field, you know, list A has, pages library has all, you know, the title and the link kind of thing.
Oh.
The name column with the link to the document. When she does a lookup from list B, she only gets a title, but when people click on it, she cannot actually get to the document directly. Is that right, Susan?
Yes.
Yes, and she wants to be able to pick column B as opposed to column A in the lookup field value, right?
Right.
I don't think it's available. I think it only does the primary ID column in the lookup field.
Well, ID is one of them. Would that help me?
No, that's probably not. No, sorry. ID is not, I mean, unless you do custom SSLT or something. You know what? Yeah, like jQuery, something like that. You know, on a list view, you can probably modify the SSLT to get that thing done. But you don't see the other
list
column.
View?
You don't. Yeah, something like that. Or the column that's coming in, you can probably do it a calculated column and point it or something. But
another idea. Why don't and guys, correct me if I'm going completely wrong path. What if we have a calculated column on that pages library, and that can we set a calculated value to be just the URL for the page, and then expose this calculated value in a dropdown?
That would be great. I have no idea at all how to do that.
Here's one thought, right? And forgive me for interrupting, Natalya, but have you tried doing like a data view web part? Because in a data view web part, you can do all these things very easily, right? As opposed to just like, you know, so in your link, you can just do that lookup column, but on your, wherever you're using this, create a data view web part, and then you can modify all this SSLT and take advantage. Even if you had the ID column, you can modify that column to become a hyperlink and then put in the whole link with the slash ID at the, you know, ID equal to at ID kind of thing. I think there are a lot of articles on that.
This is Laura. I just kind of blogged about that like a couple of days ago, and I did a screencast on how to create a hyperlink in a data view web part. So
yeah,
you might go to my blog. It's kind of right there on the front if you need to know how to do that.
That's
all right.
The
I'll
best
definitely
option.
Look at that. Okay. And I can make that multi-value?
Yeah. Yeah, you should. I mean,
you can concatenate things together, right, if you need to. You just formulate the URL however you need to do.
So think about this, right? When you set up the lookup field, you have the setting saying allow multiple selections, right?
Right.
So let's say for the sake of argument, you select the ID column, which is pretty much useless because nobody understands numbers. But you select five IDs, and that's available in your field. When you go to the data view web part, that column has the five IDs, okay, separated by semicolon. You now edit the data view web part, put in your SSLT. You have to parse the existing string because they will be available as a string. So you have to parse the existing field value, you know, separate them out, and then for every, you know, item you find, you have to pretty much massage the data and make it a URL kind of thing. And, you know,
okay,
like Laura said, if you look at Laura's, you know, presentation, you will understand how to do it for one. You obviously will have to do some more because I'm assuming she's only doing it for a single field with a single value kind of thing. But, you know, once you get into SSLT, you have the string options that allow you to parse the data. And then once you have it parsed, just follow her example to add a hyperlink to it.
Okay. All right. I did not write down the blog information. Can I get that from here somewhere? Can you go back to the first page? Or
my blog is SharePoint911.com.
Thank you for listening to a highlighted segment of SharePoint Shop Talk. Join us live and ask your own questions every Thursday, 12:30 to 1:30 p.m. You may also join our group on LinkedIn at SharePoint Shop Talk. That's our group name. And we hope that you can join us. We look forward to the continued sharing of SharePoint knowledge.